Actual living plants have a complex terpene profile, and one plant can contain over 150 individual terpenes. But these botanical terpene blends are not the same thing. Terpenes are responsible for the smell of pine trees, lavender plants, fresh oranges, and that dank smell that comes off your favorite bud. But terpenes do way more than just give your bud that great smell. They also determine how you will feel and what medicinal benefits you will get. And since these terps are so tasty and so important, companies everywhere are infusing edibles, topicals, tinctures, and vape oils with all kinds of different terpene blends to create custom flavors and effects. And depending on what product you get, you could end up with real cannabis terpenes, botanical terpene blends, or even synthetic terpenes made in a lab. We're about to cover the differences between all these different types of terps, and we're going to look at why these fake terpene blends just aren't the same. And we learn fun facts about weed like this every week, so make sure to subscribe if you want to put some nuggets of knowledge into your strain brain. Natural cannabis terpenes help the plant grow by repelling harmful insects and attracting pollen spreaders. But they also play a huge role in the medicinal properties of the plant. A 2018 review showed that CBD with the full spectrum of terpenes was 4 times more potent than CBD isolate alone, and it worked better to treat epilepsy. And a 2021 study found that terpenes mimic cannabinoids and produce similar pain-relieving effects, which are amplified when the two are used together. So the science on terpenes is still very new, but what we have learned so far has taught us that terpenes are very important for the way cannabis will make you feel and the medicinal benefits you will get from a given plant. There are 12 to 15 main terpenes that usually show up on analytical tests in large amounts, but we know that cannabis also produces hundreds of other terpenes in very small trace amounts. Most analytical testing only shows us the main terpenes, so most of the time we don't even know everything that is in our plant sample. But as more research keeps coming out, we are finding that these terpenes play a vital role in the way cannabis affects the human body. There are also fully synthetic terpenes, and synthetic terpenes aren't made from a plant at all, but instead are made through chemical manipulation and blending in a lab. Synthetic terpenes attempt to mimic the smell and flavor and effects of real terpenes, but they never really quite get it right. These synthetic terpenes can be made in really large amounts, so they're really cheap to use. But synthetic terpene science is still in its early days of experimentation, and we still don't have any evidence to prove that these synthetic terpenes are even safe to use. There is also a third option, which is botanical terpenes. Botanically derived terpenes are terpenes that are derived from plants, just not from cannabis plants. These are the exact same terpenes that are in cannabis, but they are just extracted from another botanical source. Most of these are considered food safe, but there is still very little information known about vaping them. So you might want to stay away from synthetic terps, but botanical terpenes seem like they would be all right. I mean, they're made naturally in other plants, and they're the exact same terpenes that are found in cannabis. But botanical terpenes have their problems too. Chemical News and Engineering claims that some companies are infusing products with non-cannabis terpenes at concentrations much higher than what is naturally found in cannabis flowers. And when you're getting into terpene concentrations of like 15% and above, it can really be irritating to your lungs and even your skin. Has this ever happened to you? Leave a comment, let me know if it has. But even if you are using botanical terpenes in what you think are safe amounts, you will still never be able to recreate the very complex terpene profile from a real cannabis plant. They might test for like the top 15 terpenes in a strain and try to recreate the smell of those top 15 terpenes. But they aren't even testing for a lot of the terpenes that are in the plant that are only there in really small trace amounts. So it might smell really close to the strain you're going for, but it won't ever exactly be like the real thing. To really get the terp profile the same as the plant grew it, you would have to match every single little compound in terpene that the plant grew, and you would have to match them all in the same ratios that the plant grew it with. But that isn't what's happening with these botanical terpene blends at all. They're just trying to mix a few of the main terpenes to get something that smells close. They usually aren't thinking about the medicinal benefits of the terpenes at all. And for that exact same reason, even cannabis-derived terpenes that are added back into the product at the very last step of production aren't always the best. If they didn't extract all of the terpenes from the living plant and then reintroduce them back into the product in the same exact ratios as what was in the living plant, it might not work as well as the raw plant would have. And even though we do still have a lot to learn about the science of the entourage effect and how all of these terpenes and cannabinoids work together, we do already know that they work better when they are together in something like a full spectrum extract. Full spectrum extracts have all of the terpenes and cannabinoids that were present in the living plant, and they all work together in the entourage effect to give you the best possible buzz and medicinal experience. Just watch out, because some companies will claim to have full spectrum CBD products when they're just adding in a few botanical terpenes at the end of the process. Make sure you always check the actual ingredients and the lab test for all of your products. And if you want to stay up to date with new fun facts about weed every week, make sure you click that subscribe button. We do live stream smoke session hangouts every Monday and new fun facts about weed every Thursday.